Thank you. Good afternoon. I wanted to make an art project in the old city of Jerusalem. And you know, Jerusalem, well, that's a tense place, a chaotic place. It's also a place of beautiful symbols, symbols of peace, symbols of coexistence, symbol of diversity. And usually the stories in Jerusalem are very big. It's about the origin of man or our future. Even the apocalypse is supposed to take place there. I was wondering, what are the small stories? What small stories are there? What is the present actually giving about the people who go to work, go to school, they eat breakfast, they make love, they fall asleep, they make music? What about them? So that was my plan, to connect a local artist to a foreign artist, and together they could react on a local situation, a place, a location there in the old city. So I started to work connecting people, and then I received a letter. It was from a small theater group, a partner organization. They asked me, can you officially declare that your project is not part of the peace process? I was confused. Who's against peace? Well, and we had talked that this project could be great to connect people, to create more openness, and to work to a different and a very peaceful future, you know? So what was the problem with peace process? And then he explained that for years he was part of projects bringing Palestinian and Israeli artists together, creating great symbolic work, showing to the world that they could work together, could live together, and that it's possible to be together. And in the same time, what actually happened was that the occupation became more permanent, that there was a lot of settlements built, a lot of construction work done. So he became aware that this artistic world work was more as like a veil to conceal the reality, a grim reality, a violent reality. And he didn't want that anymore. He said, I don't want to create hope when I cannot deliver something concrete, you know? Well, I agreed. So we started to work on something concrete. We started to talk with the local people, asking, can we use your bedroom? Can we use your place? Can we make a performance? Can we create music in your house? And people were so open. It was really a surprise. They say, you're welcome. My house is your house. Then at a certain moment, another Palestinian artist asked me, like, is this public event? Who is invited? I say, everyone. Well, if you invite everyone, I cannot be myself. I cannot be an artist. I mean, I can create something, but it will be just very safe, very superficial, because if there is everyone in front of me, I will become a spokesperson of my people. I will become ambassador of Palestine because of our situation. And if you want me to be an artist, if you want me to be myself, to do something, well, if to show my vulnerability, I need to know who's in front of me. Can I trust them? Who are they? So I had to decide, shall we make open, nice festival with a great symbolic art, and everything would be nice and smiling and maybe superficial? Or shall we create a space where this person, the local artist, could really express their doubts, express their vulnerability? And, well, I chose the second. Then I explained to the organization who were supposed to support this type of work that it would be a private event, on invitation only. And they said, oh, we cannot support that, because we want that culture is open and it breaks all divisions and it's opening up everything. So that's our goal, that's our mission, and so on. Even the Dutch representative office, the officer explained to me, like, look, in the Netherlands, we support a two-state solution. So if you bring Israeli and Palestinian together, we might be able to support you financially. But if you only focus on one community, that's not fundable. So I had the feeling that he wanted to take a shortcut. He explained that maybe a strategy to make peace by bringing people together, smile on the picture, and make a signature under it, and go, you know? I had a feeling that that would just never really deliver something real, you know? So we created this event. It was private. We invited people. They could invite their friends. It was full. We had a lot of, well, very intimate moments. But I'm not sure if we created peace. You know? I actually became really fed up with that slogan. I feel it's almost a holy thing. And if we talk so easy about peace, we might really, 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 like, it might wear thin. We might really lose the meaning of what is peace. I think peace is something beautiful, something sometimes far away. But to talk about it, we always need to be more honest and say, what peace are we talking about? Just the word itself conceals the reality. Is it dignity? Is it respect? Is it connection between people? Or is it security? Is it maybe just a deal? So I want to ask to you, if you use that word peace, make sure you feel a warning. Say, like, what peace am I talking about? If you hear anybody talking about peace, ask, what peace are you talking about? What real can you deliver? Peace can be up somewhere on a ladder. What are those steps? If you want real peace, that means people should be really connected, you know? What is the condition to become connected? You need to be to see each other. So you need perception, you need knowledge. How can you get knowledge and perception? You need to be curious. When are you curious? It's when you're open. What's the condition to be open? Well, it's a good question. You need to trust the situation where you're in. So I'm sure that we worked on trust. It was really under in the letter. We forgot peace, but we did something real. And that's also something I want to tell anyone working on art, creative things. It's great to work on symbols. Symbols are beautiful. But there is a danger to forget about real progress. I think any project, any artwork should do something real. It should tell us something real. It should give us a real experience and not just a symbolic one. Thank you.